sit on your left hand. So the palm is flat, the left buttock is pressing on the hand. You open the opposite side up as you inhale. And you catch the side of your head to take the head gently away from the shoulder. Do not allow your palm to come off the floor. Press the palm down. Close your eyes. The chin can come slightly towards the chest. It's a safer way of doing the lateral stretch. Press your palm, press the wrist. Elongate torso up, inhale. And exhale softly through the nose. Feeling that gentle opening in the neck, in the upper trapezius. Keep doing that at the same time. Send the heart a little further forward. And bring the belly in when you exhale. Gently. And come out. Use your hands to push your head back up. So the neck doesn't have to go tense straight away. Switch side. Make sure you activate your Ujjayi breath. For those who are not familiar or not familiar yet, Ujjayi breath is a breath with awareness around the throat. So you let the throat create a little constriction around the breath to create that whispering sound. Chin down slightly. Press the palm and the wrist down. Move the heart forward. And ease your head up using your hands to push the head up. Then interlace fingers behind the neck. Interlace fingers behind the neck. Send elbows forward alongside the jaw. Breath in. As you breathe out, you lift your head a bit higher. Then you relax your hands by the sides, close your eyes. Relax fingers, relax arms and shoulders. Keep the heart high above the hips. Take both arms up and look up towards the ceiling. The palms moving towards each other and you look up. Breathe in, lift the ribs up. Before the hands touch, turn them away from each other and bring the palms down. Now notice what is the pace of your movement, what is the pace of your breath. Synchronize the two and make them both slow. Breath in, slowly. Let your hands indicate the volume of breath. Exhale. Send the energy back down to the earth. Keep the shoulders down. Inhale, lift the ribs up and your arms and your heart. Look up. Exhale. Now inhale with the fingertips pressing down behind the hips. Lift the heart and breathe in. Exhale to curve the spine. The chest bone comes down towards the belly. The belly comes in. Inhale, lift your heart as high as you can. Press the sit bones down. Shoulders roll back. Chin down. And exhale. Send the spine towards the back with plenty of space between the vertebrae. Relax the throat. One more time, breath in. Lift everything up. Look up. And breath out. Chin to chest. curve the spine down. Now notice which leg is forward, which leg is closer to the body. Bring one hand at the back. Let's say bring the right hand at the back. Open the left side up. And breathe out to come into a very gentle twist. Stay in your ujjayi breath. That's the most important thing. Stay connected to that way, that sensation of the breath. Inhale to find more space within the body, within the rib cage. Exhale to soften shoulders down and twist chin above the chest, belly coming in. Inhale through the nose. Exhale through the nose, the back shoulder, your right shoulder moves back. You keep the heart high and the belly comes in. Exhale through the nose. Keep listening to your throat, your ujjayi breath. Stay here for a few breaths. If you want to go a bit deeper, go deeper, but not from the neck, from the mid spine, the thoracic spine, with shoulders down. Come back to the center. Close your eyes for a moment. Notice how you're feeling both sides of the body. And go to the other side. Left arm at the back, the hands behind the sacrum, not too far back. You don't want to lean back. Stay upright. Right hand outside of the left knee. You lift the heart up, you inhale. You exhale through the nose, chin above the chest to twist gently. Belly comes in. Shoulders down. Spine long, spacious. Now let's come back to the center and change the legs. Take the other leg forward. And we're going to do one more round on each side. Right hand goes back. Left hand outside of right knee. Press the sit bones down. Lift your heart towards the ceiling, inhale. Relax the jaw, exhale. Back to center, come out of the poses, always very gently, to switch. Chin to chest, the heart moves up, inhale. Rotate to exhale. Back to the center. Now, if you have a block, grab a block. If you don't have a block, grab a cushion. Big one that you can roll to make something a bit thick and compact. And you bring that between the thighs to squeeze whatever you've got between the inner thighs, close to the ground, you squeeze between the thighs and you come on your back. With the feet up, spread the toes. Interlace fingers behind head and neck with both elbows pointing up. Shoulder blades off the mat. Rest your head in your hands, the back of your head. Look up towards the ceiling. Relax your face. Spread the toes. Send the breath deep towards the pubic bone and the lower back. Then hold the breath in the lower belly and curl the tailbone up. Send both elbows towards the left knee and exhale through the nose to lower the belly. Then squeeze the block. Release the squeeze a little. Inhale, shoulder blades down. Hold the breath, curl the tailbone up, elbows towards the right knee, both elbows, not just the one. Squeeze the block, exhale, belly comes down. Inhale, expand. Curl tailbone up, hold the breath in, elbows to the left knee. Squeeze the block. Inhale, expand. Hold the breath, curl the tailbone up. Elbows to the other knee. Squeeze the block between the thighs. Empty the breath. Come down, remove the block, bring the feet down. Take one leg up. And one leg straight, so both legs to a 90 degree angle. Cut the toes down. Send both arms forward. Take the shoulder blades off the mat. Breath in. As you exhale, you slowly bring your torso closer to the vertical leg. Come down, inhale. Go up, exhale. Breath in, down. Breath out, up. Inhale, bring your awareness to your core. Expand, invite the breath in. Then exhale, bring the belly down. Exhale through the nose, reach forward. Come back down, shoulder blades down. Switch legs without bringing the feet down. One leg straight, pointing forward, one leg reaching up, curl the toes down. Elongate both arms, inhale, shoulder blades off the mat. Exhale to lower the belly and lift the torso just a little. Inhale, breathing out. Keep the toes active. Inhale, breathe out and hold. And come down, take a full body stretch. Ah. Wiggle the hips around a few times. Then bring the knees to the chest. Open the knees wide. Bring your hands on the knees and rotate on the lower back a few times. In both directions. Then bring the knees together, the feet flat, lower knees on one side. Keep the upper back connected to the mat. You can open your arms into a cross or take arms above your head if you prefer. Keep the big toes touching the floor. Bring the knees up, breath in. Lower knees to the other side, breath out. Inhale, knees up, exhale, knees to the side. Do that a few times on both sides. Move slowly, breathe at the same pace through the nose. And listen to your ujjayi breath. Make it louder than what you feel or think is the right way to do it. Usually the mind tries to downplay everything, thinking of maybe I look or sound ridiculous, which may be the case, but who gives a F? Bring the knees, the hands behind the knees, behind the thighs, and gently press down. Start to rock on the back, chin to chest. Make your spine long and start to press the spine down as you rock back to front. Inhale as you rock back. Exhale as you rock forward. come forward, cross the legs, and come into a plank. Spread your fingers wide, the thumbs as well, and push the heels back. Push the chest away from the mat. Now bring the knees down for the first one. Stay here. Notice how you feel in your arms, in the chest. As you exhale, move the chest slightly forward and down between your hands. Keep the butt higher than they hit the chest. Bring the chest down, then flatten the whole body. Flatten the whole body. Elongate the legs. And move your hands forward. Let's come into a very gentle cobra with plenty of sensation, body awareness. Lengthen the legs. Curl the tailbone down towards the floor. Feel the butt squeezing towards the back of the thighs. Lift your heart, move the chest slightly forward, slightly up, shoulders back. Press the palms down and the 10 fingers. Breathe in and breathe out to slowly come down. Move your hands below the shoulders. Come into downward facing dog. Now come on the tip of the toes, send everything up, the lower back, the mid back, the upper back. As you exhale, you slowly lower the armpits and the chest and the heels. Inhale to elongate the back of the legs. Come on the tip of the toes. Send the butt higher and the lower back and the mid back. Exhale to lower armpits, chest and the heels. Arms straight, shoulder blades rotating out, or the arms rotating out. Bend the legs, look forward, and step to the front of your mat. Come to a long flat back, fingertips down maybe, and you look forward, you send the chest bone forward. Press the hands, breath out, step the left foot back in a lunge. The heel is off the ground, hands on the hips, tilt the pelvis forward until you feel the hip flexors here reacting. Then lift the ribcage a bit higher and push the heel back to the floor. Keep facing forward and take both arms up, warrior one. Bring the lower belly slightly in and lift the lower ribs up. Then open to warrior two. Torso not leaning forward. Breath in and breath out. Bring the arms into eagle. The right leg is forward. Bring the left elbow under the right one. Lift elbows up, bring tailbone under. Inhale, exhale to fold, keep the hips low. Relax neck. Press the feet down, elbows forward. If your left leg is back, bring the left hand flat, close to the left foot, right hand on the right thigh. Thumb in, the four of the fingers on the top of the thigh. Breathe in, spread the ribs. Breathe out, try to straighten your right arm, pushing the thigh out, away from the right rib cage. The foot pointing forward. Take 5 breaths here. Slow breath. And feel your body. Come to that place where you feel. And notice, how do you react to what you feel? two more breaths. Straighten the back leg, the left leg. Exhale to open the hip, push, roll the thigh out. Relax the neck and the face. One more breath in and out. Slowly come back up to warrior two. Flip the front palm, reach forward, inhale. Keep the hips low and reverse. The left hand on the left leg. Slide the hands down to along the leg and look down towards the back foot. Now feel the opening in the opposite side, then drive the shoulder down and spread the ribs more. Then come back to a plank. Push the heels back, bring the knees down, lower the chest between your hands, empty the breath. Come all the way down flat, cobra. Elongate the legs, the feet, the toes, downward facing dog, breathe out. Take a breath in, bend the legs slightly. Breathe out, push the hips back, roll arms out, shoulders away from the neck. Push the heels down and the belly comes in down dog. No round back. Lengthen your spine. Breath in, lower the knees down. Breathe out, push the kneecaps back. Lift the tailbone. Step the left foot between your hands. Start with a lunge like we did on the other side. Adjust your pelvis, tilt it forward, then push the back heel down. Take both arms up. Open to warrior two. Bring plenty of space between your shoulder blades. Lengthen the spine up, curl the tailbone down. Breathe in softly. Breathe out softly. Maybe you relax the jaw. Maybe you smile. Maybe you activate your fingers to become more aware of the body, more present. Eagle arms, right arm under the left this time. The left foot is forward. You lift elbows up and you bring tailbone under to pull the belly in slightly. Relax the face, the gaze, the cheeks, fall forward. Do not bring elbows to the belly, send them forward. Open that space between your ribs, breathe in. Feel your back, feel the lower back, the hip joint, the feet pressing down. Relax your neck. Then bring the right hand flat, close to the right foot, left hand on the left thigh. Make sure the front foot, the left foot points forward. Breathe in, expand between your ribs. Breathe out to push the left thigh away from the left ribs. Open your chest, inhale. Exhale with your palm, pushing the left thigh. Lower the hips. Two more breaths, stay in the pose. One more breath, make the breath slow. Back to warrior two. Flip the front palm, reach forward. Elongate the right arm alongside the right leg and reverse to a peaceful warrior. Not warrior, but warrior. Relax your neck. Bring the chin to the chest. Bring the belly in. Curl the tailbone under. Create more space between the left ribs. So bring the shoulder down slightly and lift the ribs more. Lower the hips. Hands down. High plank with the knees down if you want. Squeeze the elbows towards the ribs. As you lower the chest, you empty the breath. Come all the way down. All the way down, flat on the front side. Bring one cheek down. Turn the palms to face up. And relax the jaw. Keep your eyes closed, stay in that pose for a moment and notice which part of the body in that pose, lying down flat, no effort, no muscular engagement whatsoever, which part of your body do you feel the most vibrant? To which part can you relate more? This pose activates or reactivates, energizes, balances the first and second chakras, the root chakra, the sacral chakra. So all this area around the hips, the groin, the sacrum, the lower back, maybe that's the part that you feel the most alive. Any and every tension that you can feel around those parts, really breathe out to release them completely to the ground, to the earth. Just notice what you feel. Maybe you feel energy coming out from the lower back when you breathe in. Or maybe you relate just to the sensation of movement between your ribs, in your belly, relaxing shoulders and face. Then slowly come out, interlace fingers behind the lower back. We're going to activate now. We're still connected to the earth very much through the whole body. So root and sacrum are still, root chakra, sacral chakra, are still very much energized, but we're going to activate also the solar plexus here. So pull the arms back, bring the shoulder blades together, elongate both legs, spread the toes, send the shoulders further back and start to stretch your abdominal muscles to lift your heart. Breathe deep towards the lower abdomen and take your hands off your butt. Look forward and embrace the fire. Spread the ribs, breath in, lift your heart more. Activate the legs more. Press the palms together. Soften the face. Two more breaths. And come down, bring the other cheek down. And let all tensions, worries, fears be absorbed by the earth. Really breathe it out. So you can invite something of a different nature with the next few breaths. What do you want to invite in? What do you want to feel? You decide. Wiggle the hips around a few times. And come to a puppy pose. after the gentle back bend but fiery one that we've just done, maybe a puppy pose is just what you need. So keep the hips above the knees. Elongate your arms forward. And relax the whole torso down. Be active in your arms and hands here. Not casual. Elongate the torso. Give a gentle stretch around the area of the armpits and upper ribs. Stay here for a moment. Spread your fingers. Slow down your breath. And slowly move on the forearms and come into a plank on the forearms. Now turn the right forearm and come into a side plank on the forearm. Press the hands down and lift the hips as high as you can. Take the other arm up. Hold it and breathe. Squeeze the perineum, the pelvic floor. Squeeze it. Breathe between the ribs. Relax the jaw. And slowly come out to switch side. Move in and out slowly. In and out of the pose slowly. Connect with the floor. Pressing firmly against the earth. Action, reaction. What you give is what you get. So the more presence and engagement you exert against the earth, the more strength you get into your pose. Slowly come out, downward facing dog. Walking on the spot slowly. Push both kneecaps back, tailbone up. Belly comes in when you exhale. Rotate the arms out. You don't want your neck squeezed between the shoulders. Make shoulders wide. Ujjayi breath. Then take the left leg up, but keep the hips square. You don't want to rotate the hips at this point. Keep both hips facing down. Elongate the leg, press the hands down. And then step left foot forward. And coming to a twist, the knee down is a suggestion. Personally, I prefer to do my lunge twist with the knee off the ground. I feel more mobility, more freedom in the possibility of torsion. When the knee's down, it's kind of locking my pelvis in a fixed position, which doesn't really help with the twist. We are not built the same way, so maybe it works better for you with the knee down. Come into a twist, stay in the twist for 3 or 4 breaths. And the heart not lying on the thigh, create space in the torso, inhale. And as you exhale, top shoulder rolls back. And you look down, relax the neck, chin down slightly. Soften the face. One more breath, inhale. Expand around the heart center. Exhale, belly comes in. And come out. Bring the knee down. And push the back foot back. Let's now lower the hips. Send the back foot as far back as you can. Start with the torso alongside the left thigh here. And then take the torso up, keep the hips low. Bring the torso up by pressing on the thigh gently. Press the feet, both feet down. Lift your heart, drive shoulders down, release the tension around the face. Now bring both hands flat here, inside of the foot. Bring the back foot on the toes, the heel off the ground. Lift the kneecap off the mat and send your spine high towards the ceiling. See, my left knee is connected to my left shoulder, and I just push my back high, my lower back. Look back towards the back foot. Keep lifting your spine up, and then start to bend the arms to lower the shoulders. But keep the spine high, lower the arms, look back, not forward, back. Catch your ankle, your left ankle, and bring your head as close to the ankle as you can. Breathe, embrace the intensity by bringing more breath. If you do not breathe, what will run through each cell of your body is not the energy of breath, it will be the energy of fear. So switch to feeling the body, invite more breath. One more breath, embrace the pose, press the feet down, breathe in, lift the spine, bring the belly in, and relax down. Back to downward facing dog. Let's find some solace in this down dog pose. Spread your hands, rotate the arms out, out, out. Tailbone, the hips moving back, tailbone up. Move the kneecaps back. Take a deep breath in. Sigh out. Right leg up, straight leg, straight arms. Lower the armpits a little. Look down. Shoulders rolling out. Step forward. Lunge. Lunge twist. Maybe use the elbow out to create leverage. Maybe you just come into a twist like this to feel the core. Inhale through the nose, ujjayi breath. Throat is active. You can feel, you can hear it. Stay in the twist. Make it a little deeper maybe. You've got plenty of space now. You've been opening, breathing space a lot, activating core. Breathe. And come out. Come out, move the back foot as far back as you can. And lengthen your torso, with both hands down here. Lengthen the torso forward, let the hips sink. And then slowly, push the torso up, keep the hips low. Try to create more space between the hips and the lower ribs. So it's not about sending the shoulders up, it's about gently lifting the lower ribs up. Bring the hips down a little. Check with your face, is it relaxed? Is it holding fear? Of course not. Coming out slowly. Bring your hands flat. The right knee by the right shoulder. Back foot on the ball of the foot. Activate the leg. Press against the floor. Engage against the earth. Breathe in. Open the space between shoulder blades. As you breathe out, push the spine up, the belly comes in, translates the heat from the core now to the spine by pulling the belly in. Relax the neck, look back slightly. Breathe in more, then bend the arms to lower the right shoulder. Maybe the shoulder comes under the thigh, maybe not. But go to catch the right ankle.
The secret is to keep the spine as high as you can. If the spine is down here, you cannot have space to squeeze yourself in. Create plenty of space, then lower the arms and catch the right ankle. Breathe and come out. Puppy pose again. Maybe this time you send the arms further forward. Press the feet down. Elongate the space between the ribs, then slowly bring the chest down. Let's move the fingertips forward a little. Relax armpits down. Slowly come out. Bring the knees forward, cross the legs. Come to a seated position and come on your back. Feet together. Make sure you can touch your feet here. Curl the tailbone up. Lift the hips off. Notice how your weight is shifting on each vertebra as you lift the hips. The weight is moving from the mid back to the upper back. Keep lifting, keep lifting. Curl the toes up. Squeeze the shoulder blades towards each other. Lift your heart, open the ribs here. Can interlace fingers behind the butt, behind the back. And lift your heart as much as you can. Breathe. Press the feet, curl the toes up. And slowly come down to a butterfly pose. Connect the feet, let the knees fall out to the side. And rock from side to side gently. Take a deep breath in. Exhale loudly, fully. And come into your bridge again. Or maybe wheel. If you want to come into wheel, you place your hands here, just by your ears, fingers pointing towards the shoulders. Breathe, lift the tailbone, the hips, press the hands and the feet down. And slowly come down, lower back coming down last. Butterfly pose, connect the knees, the sole of the feet, curl the toes out. One hand on your heart, one hand on the belly. Close your eyes. Breath in, full breath out. Now take your arms above your head, catch the elbows, and let your elbows and shoulders rest. Come down slowly towards the floor. Holding your elbows, take them a bit higher to spread the ribs a bit more away from the hips. Close your eyes. Feel your abdomen, your solar plexus, your sacrum. Your pelvic floor. your throat, your heart space, the space between your eyebrows. Relax all those areas. Relax the tongue in your mouth. And take both arms, long, relaxed. Relax the wrist, the palms, the fingers, and take both legs up. Rotate the ankles a few times. In all directions. Then curl the toes down towards your chest. Breathe in, press the sacrum down. Breathe out, lift the ball of the feet, bring the belly in. Inhale, curl the toes down. Lengthen the back of the legs. Exhale, push the ball of the feet up. And then bend the legs. Gently press the shin bones down. Wrap the arms around the shin bones if it's available to you. Gently press towards the ribs, but also press the knees. You press the shin bones down and the knees towards each other to maximize opening of the lower back. Do that a few times. Make sure you empty the belly, so the stomach doesn't offer any resistance to that movement of the thighs. Activate the toes. Then come into happy baby pose. Grab the feet, keep the lower back connected to the mat, and lower the knees towards the armpits. Stay here for a moment. Close your eyes. And let it be. Whatever is, let it be. Soften into it. Do not compromise with the verticality of your lower legs. Don't bring the legs over the butt here. Make sure the feet are above the shoulders. Let the thighs come down slowly. Then grab the big toes and open the legs wide. Pull on the big toes. Stay here for 5 breaths. Notice the willingness to resist. Breathe in, squeeze the thighs to indicate to the other side of the thigh to elongate and release tension. See how it works, see how it feels. Breathe in, squeeze the quads, curl the toes towards the shoulders, let the legs open, breathe out, belly down. 3 more breaths. And release. Choose the most comfortable pose. Maybe sometimes you want to try Shavasana on the front side or on the side with some cushions. Make your life comfortable, at least in this moment. It's good to step out of the comfort zone, but there are moments where, no, comfort is what we deserve and what we need. And what's beneficial. Shavasana is one of those moments. Come to that place and allow yourself to relax completely for a few minutes. This ship that we call the body. It's conscious ship. Send your awareness to every part of the body. Your breath, your attention. Gratitude. Yes, gratitude, it's not just a word, it's really important that we come to realize that we cannot spend our life worrying about what could be, what could go wrong. Let's come to realize what is happening for us, is this body is happening for us constantly. So let's have gratitude for that. Gratitude also towards yourself, towards the awareness that is driving you towards doing this work. And then surrender to the peace of your body. To the peace of your breath. slowly. Bring your attention back to the physical body. Let your senses go outwards again, outwardly. Feel, sense your environment. Breathe deeper. Bring some little movements in the body. In your own time, come up to a seated pose. Connect your hands by your heart. Connect the palms, the fingers, the fingertips. Feel the pattern, the prints, fingerprints. Feel your face. Lengthen the spine up, inhale. Soften shoulders down, exhale fully. Bring the thumb knuckles on the third eye, or maybe it's the first eye, who knows. And let's bow forward to acknowledge ourselves and each and every one of us.